Brain Crack. I'm actually kind of the same as Avery on this one. I think a lot about conversations that I never end up having, particularly just like you were talking about with, you know, friends of mine that I may be having issues with. It's happened a lot in, you know, high school when things were going crazy. But then in real life, I would not say anything ever. Also, on the occasion that I like somebody, I will think a lot about conversations that I could have with them. And again, those never happen because I'm a coward. And I'm afraid, with good reason, that the things that come out of my mouth when I'm actually there won't be the witty things that come out of my mouth in my imaginary world. As far as, like, ideas for stuff go, a lot of them are, you know, ideas for stories and stuff. And then if I'm reading a good book or if I watch a really good movie, my brain sort of gets stuck in almost the voice of that movie or that book. Like, sometimes it's, you know, literally thinking about characters and plots and what I would do or what I think should have happened or just thinking about it in general. But sometimes it's like a mood. Like, an author's voice will get stuck in my head. And then I start thinking that way, which is a problem when I'm reading Shakespeare or Austen or something. And actually, Meredith, on the subject of time travel, I had quite a brain crack addiction after the thesis that Bethany was in about as a kid who wakes up in his past and stuff, imagining what would happen if I woke up in middle school. For some reason, I had got really fixated on if I woke up and I was back in, like, eighth grade somewhere, what would I do? And I had lots of fun thinking about I could go to the Deathly Hallows premiere again, watch Vlogbrothers from the beginning. I could try to go see Harry Potter musical, like, on opening night. I would so do that. I would so get plane tickets and fly out to Michigan and be like, there, first night. No one else would be as excited as I would be, because I would be like... But then that gets to sort of depressing things, like, I would have to try to get my grandmother to have her lungs checked, and I would have to try to not do certain things with friends that ended up ruining friendships, decide if I wanted to come to Simon's Rock at the same time, because there's no way I'm going back to high school. I'm getting my GED and I'm not doing that again. Yeah. So that's all of the brain crack of mine that I can think of right now.